What's happening, Polite Society? I hope you had a good week. Today, I'm going to be providing some thoughts on Artur Pawlowski. So, let's delve in. Hello, everyone. If you're here for the first time, welcome to my channel. I'm Alan. For those of you unaware, Artur Pawlowski, and I do apologize if I'm pronouncing his last name incorrectly, but Artur Pawlowski is a religious leader who has received a lot of media attention lately. This has primarily been due to a few clashes he has had with Canadian authorities. The video in which he loudly ordered police out of his chapel went viral. Since then, he has been interviewed by a number of media outlets, including Fox News. He was also arrested. Many, both within the church and outside it, have been praising Mr. Pawlowski. But how should we as Christians feel about his behavior? Well, in Ephesians 4:15, Paul writes, "But speaking the truth in love, we are to grow up in all aspects into him who is the head, that is Christ." As the great evangelist Justin Peters has pointed out, when Paul says that we are to be speaking the truth in love, that in love part is just as inspired as the speaking the truth part. In 2 Timothy 2, Paul states, "The Lord's bondservant must not be quarrelsome, but be kind to all, skillful in teaching, patient when wronged, with gentleness correcting those who are in opposition, if perhaps God may grant them repentance leading to the knowledge of the truth, and they may come to their senses and escape from the snare of the devil, having been held captive by him to do his will." So keep those two sacred texts in mind as we examine Mr. Pawlowski's behavior. As many of you are aware, Pastor James Coates has likewise been targeted by Canadian authorities. Pastor James was arrested and then held in a maximum security prison for several weeks. Thankfully, he was released not too long ago. It is noteworthy that during the entire ordeal, Pastor Coates' gracious, gentle, yet firm spirit was in stark contrast to that of Mr. Pawlowski. And the leadership at Grace Life has likewise exhibited the same calm, yet uncompromising disposition as that of their senior pastor.
Because your presence intimidates our people.
That's your perception.
Well, no.
How so?
No, and again, it's not about perception. Our people understand that you guys, and again, we respect the work that you do in the community. We respect you as police officers, but in our worship service right now, people are praying, people are singing, people are listening to the Word of God be preached, and they can't do that with your presence in the building.
And with all due respect, the law has now put our pastor in prison.
Notice how the behavior of the elders at Grace Life aligned with the apostles' teachings in Ephesians 4 and 2 Timothy 2. In striking contrast, when Mr. Pawlowski encountered Canadian authorities, he responded to their presence by angrily shouting at them and calling the officers Gestapo members, National Socialists, and psychopaths. Additionally, there are other troubling aspects about Mr. Pawlowski. Justin Peters has mentioned a bizarre post which suggests that Mr. Pawlowski adheres to Word of Faith theology. Justin also pointed out that Pawlowski went on the Victory Channel, which is Kenneth Copeland's YouTube channel. It's owned and operated by Kenneth Copeland. And as many of you who watched my 10 Worst Word of Faith Teacher series know, Mr. Copeland made it to the top of my list for worst Word of Faith teacher. Now, was what was done to Mr. Pawlowski unjust? Yes, it was. I'm not in any way defending the heavy-handed tactics that were used against him. But both his pugnacious behavior, as well as his very questionable theology, should definitely raise some major flags for all true Bible-believing Christians. I posted a link to Justin's video below. He provides a much fuller analysis and examination of this situation. In that same video, Justin also mentions another pastor who was also arrested in Canada, but who displayed a Pastor James Coates type attitude rather than that of Mr. Pawlowski. So definitely check out Justin's video. I think you will find it very useful and beneficial. Let's all continue to be in prayer for our brothers and sisters who are battling persecution, not only in Canada, but in many places all across the world. We live in perilous times, but Christ is Lord, and he will continue to build his kingdom, and the gates of Hades will not prevail against it. Ladies and gents, if you want to share your own thoughts, be sure to do so in the comment section down below. Thanks for watching, guys. If you liked that video, please give it a thumbs up. If you like the content here, you can subscribe by clicking on the icon on the bottom right. Then you can hit the bell for notifications. I upload a new video every Wednesday and every Saturday. You can also follow me on Instagram. I've posted a link below. Have an awesome week. And for my brothers and sisters in the Lord, may the grace of the Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all always. I will see you all in the next video. God's blessings on your week.